टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मास ट्रांसफर इक्विपमेंट। स्टार्टिंग विद द इक्विपमेंट फॉर गैस लिक्विड ऑपरेशन, सो द कॉमन रेंज ऑफ वैल्यूज ऑफ मास ट्रांसफर पैरामीटर इन कमर्शियल गैस लिक्विड ऑपरेशन आर टेबुलेटेड। रिसीव ट्रे प्रोवाइड 0.02.05 सुपरफिशियल गैस वेलोसिटी, वेयर इज द मास ट्रांसफर coefficient of liquid side will be 1 to 20, whereas the mass transfer from the gas side is equal to 0.5 to 6. And similarly, the value of A will is the 100 to 200. So, all other, these values are also provided for the packed column, bubble column, spray column, and mechanically agitated contactor. So, these are the indicative value, so the student can understand what the magnitude of the these quantity for the design purpose. So the major gas liquid operations include absorption, stripping, distillation, humidification and dehumidification. The main purpose of the equipment for interface mass transfer to provide intimate content of the immiscible phases. This mass transfer equipment operates in the batch or in continuous mode also. For some small production units, batch operation is preferred or used. A high degree of turbulent mixing is desired and created to disperse one phase into other to provide a large interfacial area of contact, which leads to increase the mass transfer coefficient in both sides. The mass transfer equipments are customarily designed and fabricated as per the specific requirements. So, if we classify the mass transfer equipment, two type of equipment, one is gas dispersed, other one is the liquid dispersed. So, the gas is dispersed in liquid in form of bubbles and the liquid is dispersed in the form of droplets or discontinuous film in a continuous gas phase. Sometimes both gas and liquid phases are continuous. Tray and packed column are most widely used for gas liquid contacting for gas absorption, stripping and distillation. So here the equipments are listed for the gas dispersed equipment. This is for liquid dispersed. So in case of gas dispersed, tray oblique plate column, bubble column, sieve plate column, bubble tray column, agitated vessel, sparge vessel. In case of liquid dispersed, the Venturi scrubber, wetted wall column, spray tower, packed tower. So starting with the tray or plate column. So here, presented here in this figure, so you can see the outer cell is here. This is the tray. In this case, there is the sieve tray shown here. The liquid is into the system. The downspout from the liquid from here to here is flowing down. And this is the side stream withdrawal. This is the wear. This is the fourth. The intermediate feed is provided here and from here to gas in and here to liquid out. And from here, the gas out. So, the tray of plates on which the gas liquid contact occurs. Arrangements for flow of liquid from one tray to the lower one through the downcomers. Plate tower exhibits larger pressure drop and liquid hold up at higher gas flow rate. Plate columns are normal for the fouling or laden with solids. So, here the parts of the columns are shown here and these are the symbol for this part. So this is reflux from condenser, this is vapor to condenser, this is for liquid feed, vapor from the reboiler, liquid to the reboiler, where A shows for downcomers, B for tray support, C for sieve tray, D for manway, E for outlet wear, F inlet wear, side wall for downcomers, liquid seal, active area, downcomer area, column diameter, and many more. So, if you will refer the individual component from the you can refer individual component of this figure. So a tray column primarily consists of a vertical cylindrical cell and a set of tower internals that include tray or plate on which the gas liquid contact occurs, arrangement of flow of the liquid from one tray to the lower one through the down cover, inlet and outlet nozzle for the two phases. In a gas absorption application, the liquid enters the top tray through a nozzle. It impinges on a baffle plate, moves across the tray and flow into the lower through a down cover. Mass transfer from the gas to the liquid phase occurs depending on the direction of driving forces. The liquid flow occurs a tray and then over a wear to enter into the down cover. The down cover is a region near the wall separated by a down cover plate in which the bubble gets disengaged from the liquid. The clear liquid flows to the next lower tray and each tray acts as a stage in which the liquid flowing down from the upper tray and the gas flowing up from the lower tray and comes into the contact the lower. So a wear on the tray ensures that there is always some liquid hold up on the tray, and it is designed such that the hold up is at a suitable height, example such that the bubble caps are covered by liquid. Being lighter, vapor flows up the column and is forced to pass through the liquid via the opening on each tray. The area allowed for the passage of vapor on each tray is called the active tray area. The total cross-sectional area is inside the area without tray or down slot. The total tower cross-sectional area minus the area at the top of the down cover, the net area symbolize the smallest area available for the vapor flow in the intertrain spacing. The tower cross sectional area minus sum of the down cover top area and the down cover seal area and any other non perforated area on the tray, the bubbling area represent the area available for the vapor flow just above the tray flow. Hole area, the total area of the perforation on the tray, the hole area is the smallest area available for vapor or gas phase passage. So in this figure, the schematics of tray opening in the fourth regime is shown. So this is the tray and this is the wear. When the liquid is flowing from here to here and it's coming from here here. So then the liquid is coming here and from the lower side there is some gas is coming, so there will be a formation of fourth. And this fourth regime you can see here and here and here and here, whereas this is the liquid. So in this figure, the typical cross flow plate sieve is shown here. You can see this is the active area, there is the liquid flow, and this is the fourth, this is a spray, this is the above plate, and you can see here is also fourth formation, and again here is the fourth formation. So this is the down cover apron plate below. So the fluid is coming from here, contacting the gas from here and down from here. So the classification of plate type based on the flow mode side view are shown here. One is the cross flow plate, another one is the counter flow plate. So this is the cross flow plate where the liquid is flowing in this direction and vapor is flowing in this direction. So there will be the perforation. And this is the counter flow arrangement where the liquid is flowing down and vapor is flowing up. So there are various type of tray and their arrangements. So the tray, this is the sieve tray. You can see there is a multiple perforation in this plate and you can see the small opening like a sieve. So this is why it's called a sieve tray. This is the bubble cap tray here. The bubble cap is provided on the each perforation. So this is termed as bubble cap tray. Tunnel cap tray, here there is a tunnel is provided and there are cap also. So that is the tunnel cap. This is for the floating wall tray with rectangular shape wall. So you can see this is the tray where their valve are provided. So these are the rectangular shaped valve are provided. This is the wall tray. And you can see another type of wall tray is also here. So there is a valve is provided here and this is the covering front. So based upon the flow dynamics inside the column, you can see a reverse flow like this. The fluid is flowing from here and here. So this is reverse flow. So next is the radial flow. Radial flow may be either from the periphery to the center or from center to the periphery. So these are the example for, these are the flow arrangement for the radial flow. Then cascade flow, here the flow fluid is coming from here, 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 and then goes. So there are some stepping, that is the cascade tray. And at last, this is the split flow. So you can see flow from here to here is splitted, from here to here splitted, or you can say flow like this. So the characteristics dimension of a industrial tray designs are indicated here. For the bubble cap, you can see the diameter of the cap is around 0.05 to 0.15 meter, whereas the height of wear is 0.03 to 0.1 meter. For wall tray, the spacing 0.15 to 0.025, whereas the diameter 0.04 to 0.06 meter, and you can see the wear height is around 0.01 meters. In this case, in the wear height is less than to the this much. For shift tray, the perforation is 0.05 to 0.2, whereas the diameter is from 1 to 13 millimeter. You can see here. So these are the indicative dimensions for the industrial tray designs. A wear is used to maintain a desired liquid level on the tray. The typical wear height is between 2 to 4 inch and low wears are frequently used in low pressure column. Notched wear are commonly used in the low liquid loads. The higher and the liquid level, the higher the tray pressure drop. The higher liquid level also imply more liquid hold up on the tray, which may be undesirable if the liquid is toxic or hazardous. So the wear height may vary from 60 to 80% of the tower diameter. Next is down cover. So here you can see in this diagram, the fluid is coming, liquid is coming from here to here, retain here, and then it go from here to here. So this is the column wall, this is the wear, and this is termed as down cover. So, down covers are used to guide liquid flow from an upper tray to the lower tray. A liquid along with some dispersed gas or vapor bubbles overflows the wear and enter the down cover. The down cover must provide sufficient residence time for liquid gas disengagement. So, the so at this lower level, there will be pure clear liquid rather than the that there will be clear liquid. The clear liquid velocity in the down cover normally range from 0.3 to 0.5 feet per second. So here in this diagram, you can also see the dynamics of the flow. So here the liquid is coming from here to here with the these bubbles, where these bubbles are generated by the lower gas flow of gases. So the condensed liquid overflow this wear, and here the all the remaining gases will be escaped from the liquid and the clear liquid is come to here. And again, the gases from the perforation of the tray is passes through the liquid and there will be mass transfer, some equilibrium stages, and again the similar process occurs. So this section, this section as well as this section is termed as down comer. See, this down comer plate may be straight or may be inclined. Next, the nozzle, a tower of contacting a liquid and a vapor should be provided with a few nozzles for feed entry. Entry of reflux at the top and of the revolver vapor retained at the bottom and for product withdrawn from the tower. So, primary criteria of a feed nozzle design is to ensure that the feed is introduced with minimum splashing or jetting. The feed should be evenly distributed and mixed with the internal liquid or vapor. So, next is the mist eliminator. Even under normal operating conditions, a little entrainment of liquid in the upflowing vapor may occur. So, in order to prevent entrainment in the vapor leaving to the top tray, a pad made of wire mesh or a pack of suitably bent and spaced thin sheet is fitted above the tray. So, the droplets are retained after they strike the surface of the pad, such as called mist eliminator. So, thank you. We will meet in next lecture. For your better understanding, a video clip is inserted in this lecture. So, this video clip first demonstrates the functioning of a tray column and then gives an insight into a column equipped with tunnel tray and operated with the transfer media, air and water system. So, this video is taken from the YouTube and the link